Good morning, dear students. Let us begin our lecture. Today is the theme of the lecture, the principal types of English pronunciation. Dear students, let us write down the discussion items. The principal types of English pronunciation is the first item. Second item, dialectology and dialect studies. Third item, the notion of orthoepic norm. The fourth, types and the variants of pronunciation. The next, national pronunciation standards of English in the English-speaking countries. And the last item, received pronunciation as a standard and its relations with other variants. Now, the list of literature of the today's lecture is in English, Roche P, English Phonetics and Phonology. It's printed in Cambridge University Press, 1991. And the rest literature are in Russian, Sokolova, М.А. и другие. Теоретическая фонетика английского языка, Москва, 1996 год, страницы 247-285. Соколова, М.Э., теоретическая фонетика английского языка, Москва, 1991, страницы 208-237. Леонтьева, С.Ф., теоретическая фонетика английского языка, Москва, 1980 год, 206-212 страницы. Now let us begin our lecture about the first item. The four components of phonetic structure of the language, phonemic, syllabic, accentual, and intonational, constitute its pronunciation. One of the things that everybody knows about languages is that they have different accents. Languages are pronounced differently by people from different geographical places, from different social classes, from different ages and different educational backgrounds. The word accent is often confused with dialect. We will use the word dialect to refer to a variety of language which is different from other, not just in pronunciation, but also in such matters as vocabulary, grammar, and word order. Differences of accent, on the other hand, are pronunciation differences only. Type of British English most familiar as the accent used by most announcers and news readers on serious national and international BBC broadcasting channels has for a long time been identified by the rather quaint name, received pronunciation. In talking about accents of English, the foreigner should be careful about the difference between English and Briton, about the difference between British English and American English. There are many differences, different accents in England, but the range becomes very much wider if the accents of Scotland, Wales, and Northern Ireland are taken into account. Within the accents of England, the distinction that most frequently made by the majority of English people is between northern and southern. This is a very rough division that there can be endless argument over there, the boundaries line, but most people on hearing a pronunciation typical of someone from Lancashire, Yorkshire, or other countries further north will identify it as southern. Differences among accents of English are usually a subject that many students of English find interesting and wish to know more about. For a long time, the study of accents was part of the subject of dialectology, which aimed to identify all the ways in which a language differed from place to place. In its traditional form, it is principally interested in geographical differences, exploring rural areas, finding elderly speakers. Now about the dialectology. Dialectology, best known data gathering technique, has been to send researchers, usually called field workers, mainly into rural areas where the speakers were believed to less likely to have been influenced by other accents. To find elderly speakers whose speech was believed to have been less influenced by other accents, and to preserve all the forms of the dialect, and to use lists of questions to find information about vocabulary and pronunciation. The questions being chosen to concentrate on items known to vary a lot from region to region. Surveys of this kind can provide the basis of many generalizations about geographical variation, but they have serious weakness, which will be discussed later. When two accents differ from each other only phonetically, we find the same number of phonemes in both accents, but some of all the phonemes are realized differently. There may also be differences in stress or intonation, but not such as would cause a change in meaning. As an example of phonetic difference at the segmental level, it is said that Australian English has the same set of phonemes and phonemic contrasts as received pronunciation, yet Australian pronunciation is so different from received pronunciation that is easily recognized as such. A word of caution should be given here. It is all too easy to talk about singers as Australian English and ignore the great variety that inevitably exists within such a large community of speakers. Every individual's speech, we can find differences in pronunciation as well as in other fields of linguistic analysis resulting from various factors that we could call static influences. In addition, various situational factors. Some people who usually turn out to do well in phonetic training find that in speaking to someone with a different accent, their pronunciation gets progressively more like chat of person they are speaking to, like a chameleon adapting its color to its environment. Every national variety of language falls into territorial or regional dialects. Dialects are distinguished from each other by differences in pronunciation, grammar, and vocabulary. When we refer to varieties in pronunciation only, we use them, the term accent. So, local accents may have many features of pronunciation in common and are grouped into territorial or aerial accents. For certain reasons, one of the dialects becomes the standard language of the nation and its pronunciation or accent the standard pronunciation. The literally spoken form has its national pronunciation standard. A standard may be defined as a socially accepted variety of language established by a codified norm of correctness. Standard national pronunciation is sometimes called an orthoepic norm. Some phoneticians, however, refer to the term literary pronunciation. Dear students, that's all about today's lecture. We should revise all given discussion items. We should know what's the principal types of English pronunciation, what's dialectology, and what dialect studies, or the notion of orthoepic norm, types and variants of pronunciation. How many types of pronunciation do you know? How many variants of pronunciation do you know? About national pronunciation standards of English in the English-speaking countries. And received pronunciations as a standard. Received pronunciations relations with other variants you should know. But how many components of phonetic structure of the language do you know? They are phonemic, syllabic, accentual, and intonational. You should know the definition of the word accent. But also, you should know the differences of accent with British English, with American English. You should know what is received pronunciation. You should differentiate between English and Breton accent. But you should know how many types of accents in English, but how many types of accents in America, in Scotland, in Wales, in Northern Ireland, and others. What is the difference between people in northern and southern part of the America? They are different pronunciations, you should know. But differences among accents of English are usually a subject that many students of English find interesting and wish to know more about. You should give more information, you should find more information about this case. But you should know dialectology. What is a dialectology? Why we said dialectology? Why we study dialectology? You should know Australian English, Australian English, American English, British English pronunciations, and the set of phonemes and phonemic contrasts. We should know individual speech, static influences. What is static influences? What is stational, situational factors? You should know about territorial or regional dialects. Так. Other dialects distinguished from each other by difference in pronunciation, grammar and vocabulary. You should differentiate, you should find out its similarity and differences. The literally spoken, what is literally spoken pronunciation? You should know. Standard national pronunciation is sometimes called an orthoepic norm. What is an orthoepic norm? What is literary pronunciation? Now, dear students, we have also summarized our today's lecture, the principal types of English pronunciation. If you have any questions, you are welcome. Please be ready for the next lecture, please.